been my ambition from an apprentice to always have my own place. Me and my wife are very happy. We've got one of the best locations in Leamington. Because of our location, it just ticks all the boxes with how I like to cook. My cooking style pays homage to the training that I've had, which was classical French. But again, I think with the food fashions, we're going backwards a little bit more towards the classical cooking, I think. And I think people are wanting a slightly more simpler way of eating and just enjoying the dish for what it is. Food has always been a big part of my life. I was born in Yorkshire, brought up in South Africa. My mom always encouraged me to grow my own vegetables. I've got a beef dish that I'm very proud of. It's the grazing cow, and it's a celebration of beef. We use the more unusual cuts to help educate our customers that there's more to beef than just fillet, sirloin and ribeye. We use the tongue and cheek, which is braised, and then we use the cooking liquor to, you know, rehydrate the meat. We make a parfait out of the calf's liver. We also use onglet, which is also known as hanger steak, which is part of the diaphragm. And then we marry that with some pickled mushrooms, sautéed mushrooms and raw mushrooms. We make a grass jus. All the cuts that people wouldn't normally eat, we try to elevate. But for the tongue and cheek, I tend to get a nice big container, put my tongue and cheek in together. And so we'll put carrots, leeks, celery, tomatoes go into it, turnips go into it. To enhance the meat flavor, I put cloves and star anise, because that brings out the umami effect in the meat. We just cover with water, and I'll put in my oven on steam for 85 degrees for 8 hours overnight. When I come in the next morning, I've got this beautiful tender pieces of meat. I allow it to cool down in the liquor, because if you take it out too early, it will dry out. Because of the way we're presenting the dish, I want nice grimoires of the meat. We'll reduce the cooking liquor, and that will then make be the base for all of our, for the grass sauce, and also to rehydrate the tongue and cheek. We will add gherkins to that, and then we finish it with smoked bone marrow. So we have the bone marrow with the tongue and cheek, gherkins, lovely and aromatic, smoked marrow over the top of that. And then all the rest of it, so we've got a beautiful seared medium rare piece of onglet, which has been cooked in frothing butter, garlic and rosemary. And that goes on the plate. We do a quenelle of calf's liver parfait. We've got the violet mustard polenta cubes, nice and crispy, so that adds nice texture. And so this goes into a ring, which will then hold in the sauce. And then the grass sauce goes in the middle, which represents the field that it's been grazing in. We've got pickled mushrooms, we've got raw mushrooms, and we've got sautéed mushrooms, again, building the perimeter. And then we finish it with micro herbs to represent the field. One thing I'd recommend if you're gonna try and recreate these dishes is buy the best ingredients you can. The quality of the meat makes such a difference.